Welcome students. Today we are going to start with 11th class chapter 4, that is recording of transaction part 2. In the previous chapter number 3, which was part 1 for this recording of transaction, we have studied till journal and ledger. When the business is very small, we record in journal. But as the business expands, more and more transaction means we have to divide it into special journals, which means that specific transaction of a similar type are recorded in a separate journal, like credit purchase, credit sales, credit purchase return, credit sales return, and cash entries. These are all recorded in their specific journals. These are also called day book or subsidiary books. If any transaction which is not in any specific journal, then it will be recorded in journal proper. For example, credit purchase of asset, rectification entries, etc. Now, these special journals are very economical. Now, how many type of special purpose books are there? First, cash book, which record all the cash entries. Then, purchase book, which record all the credit purchase entries. Then, sales book, which record all the credit sales entries. Sales return, credit sale return, purchase return, credit purchase return, and in the last, journal proper, those entries which do not find any place in the above mentioned books are recorded in journal proper. As I have told you, rectification entries and adjustment entries. Now, let's discuss in detail all these books, starting with cash book first. All the transactions relating to cash receipt and payment, whether they are related to goods or they are related to assets or any expense, anything which is related to cash will be recorded in this book. So, cash book serves the purpose of journal as well as ledger. Ledger means cash account. There are three types of cash book. First, single column cash book, in which there is only one column, that is cash column. Next, double column cash book, in which we are having two columns, cash as well as bank. And the next third type of book is petty cash book, in which we record all the petty expenses, small expenses. Now, let's discuss the single column cash book in detail. It starts with the debit side, and in the first point we write opening balance of cash, because it is just a single column cash book. So, we record opening balance of cash, and then we record all the receipts of cash, whether it is by cash sale of goods, whether it is by cash sale of furniture. All the things in which we receive cash are recorded on the debit side, and on the credit side, all the payments, whether it is related to goods, expenses, assets, or anything, all these payments which are related to cash will be recorded on the credit side. And then in the end, we finally arrive at the closing balance of cash. You know, debit will always be more in cash and credit will be less or equal to debit. You cannot have minus balance of cash, right? If you are having money, only then you can spend it. Now, all these entries are posted in their respective accounts also. For example, if we have received cash from Sonu, then it will be recorded in the Sonu account also, on the right hand side, and we will write by cash, because when we receive cash, we will write in the cash book on debit side, to Sonu, amount received. So in the Sonu account, it will be on the right hand side by cash. As you know, all the entries have two aspects, one debit and one credit. This was discussed in our previous classes. Next, similarly, any payment made on the credit side of the cash book. For example, if we are purchasing stationery, then we will write on the right hand side, credit side, buy stationery, and this will be recorded in the stationery account left side, that is debit side, as to cash. So in stationery account, debit side, in cash account, credit side, both aspects are there, right? Debit and credit, double entry system, Lucas Pacioli. I hope you remember all these things. Now coming to the next, double column cash book. There are two columns, as the name suggests, double column. There are two columns, one of cash and one of bank. Debit side starts with opening balance of both now, because there are two columns, so cash as well as bank, and then all the receipts of cash in cash column and the receipts of bank in bank column. Similar treatment for the credit side also. If we are paying anything in cash, it will be recorded on the credit side cash column, and if the payment is being made by check, it will be recorded in the bank account credit side, right? When all the receipts and all the payments of cash in cash column and bank in bank column are recorded, then in the end, we arrive at the closing balance of cash as well as bank. Now, one thing to note here is cash is always debit balance, that is on the credit side, and bank account can be debit balance or credit balance, because in case you have issued more checks, then it can be a negative balance, that is overdraft. We will be coming to this in our next discussion also. Now, let us discuss something about bank account. Now, generally, this is a current account, because a business opens a current account in the bank. No interest is given on this account. Instead, some service charges by the bank are made, like incidental charges, you can say. They can take some charges from you for opening the account, okay? For depositing the money, pay slips are used. You can write the amount to be deposited in cash or the checks which you want to deposit in the account. Then the bank gives you a checkbook for withdrawal of the money. Account pay check means you can deposit in that particular person account only. Now, what is a cross check? When we put two parallel lines on the face of the check, it is called cross check. Now, this crossing can be of two types. First, as I have told you, account pay, which can be deposited in the account only. But there can be special crossing also. Within those parallel lines, if you have written the name of the bank, then it can be deposited only in that particular bank, that is called special crossing. Now, suppose I give you a check with two lines on it. You can put this check in your account in any bank. But if I put a special crossing like SBI account, so you can put this check in only and only SBI account and nowhere else, because I have put a special crossing. So this is the difference, okay? Now let's talk something about contra entries. When we deposit cash or withdraw the cash, it is affected on both the sides of the cash book. Take an example. If I am receiving cash from the bank is going down on the credit side and the cash is increasing on the debit side. So, in the same cash book, there are two effects, one on the debit, one on the credit. So this is called a contra entry. We write a capital letter C in the inverted comma to signify this contra entry, and this C inverted comma is written in the ledger folio column so that we are able to know that this entry is going to affect both the sides. Now, what is overdraft? As I have told you, cash withdrawn can never be more, but you can withdraw from bank more. So, the balance will be negative. This facility is available in current account only, that is for the business. So, if the businessman is withdrawing more than what it is in his account, then it is a case of bank overdraft. Okay. Now, there is one very important point: check in hand. Suppose I receive the check today and I do not deposit it on the same day, then I will have to take it in cash. In the next day, when I will deposit this check, it will be a contra entry. Cash will be going out, that is, those checks in hand will be going out, and on the debit side, bank account will be increasing. So, that makes it a contra entry. Although this concept is not used very popularly, but this is there in the theory part. So, we must know what is check in hand. As I told you, while balancing the cash book, cash balance will never be credit, because payments can never exceed the available cash. But that's not true for bank balance, because there can be overdraft. Now, what are the source document for receipts and payment? The source document for receipt is the receipt issued by cashier, whereas for the payments, we have invoices, bills, etc., issued by the suppliers. All these are called vouchers. These vouchers are serially numbered and kept in a separate file for future reference and verification. Let's also think about a very important point: dishonor of a check and the bank charges. Dishonor of a check means bank will debit and cash book will credit. I am trying to say, in the bank account, it will be debited in the bank, and in our cash book bank column, it will be on the credit side. And similarly, bank charges, interest, commission, etc., charged by the bank will have the same effect, that is, debited in the bank and credited in cash book bank column. Let's take few examples on double column cash book. Opening balance, cash and bank will come on the debit side. If we purchase the goods, it will come on the credit side. If we sell the goods in cash, it will be on the credit side of cash column. If the machinery is purchased by check, it will be on the credit side bank column. Similarly, if we purchase stationery in cash, it will be on the credit side cash column, and when we withdraw cash from the bank, it will be a contra entry: debit in cash, credit in bank, right? And when we pay rent by check, it will be in the credit side of the bank column of cash book, credit side, because we are paying by check, and the closing balance of cash and bank will be on the credit side by balance carried down on the credit side, because if debit side is more, the balance will always come on the credit side, although it is a debit balance, because debit is more, so balance is debit. Let us check our understanding, what we have understood till now. Trade discount is recorded in which book? Yes, purchase book. And cash discount is recorded in cash book. Goods returned from customer are recorded in, not purchase return, it is sales return, because we are getting from customer sales return. And overdraft means which balance in cash book? Negative balance in cash book. Cash book does not record blank transactions. Which transactions are not recorded in cash book? Yes, credit transactions are not recorded. And if assets are sold on credit, they are recorded in which book? Yes, right. Oh, yes, it is journal proper. In double column cash book, there are two columns. Yes, which columns? Cash and bank. Next, purchase book records only which transaction? Credit purchase of goods in trade, right? Cash book serves both purpose of blank and blank. Yes, journal and ledger, because we record the entries journal and there is no need to maintain cash and bank account. So, it works as a ledger also. Next, ledger is a blank book. Yes, it is a main book. Next, any transaction recorded on both sides of cash book is dash entry, contra entry. Next, credit purchase of machine will be recorded in, yes, journal proper. So, students, today we have discussed journals and then we have told you when the business is big, we refer to specific journals like purchase book, sales book, purchase return, sales return and whatever remains in journal proper. And then we discussed about three types of cash book: single column, double column and petty cash book, which will be discussed in the next session along with purchase book, sales book, purchase return, sale return and journal proper. All these are going to be discussed in our next session. So, till then, happy reading. Thank you.